Will the monsoon make you pay less for your vegetables? Of course, we have with us Mithali Nikor, senior economist, to decode all these answers for you and to give you the answers to these big questions. Remember, retail inflation has eased to 4.75% for the month of May. Food inflation, however, remains stubborn at 8.7% in May. And core inflation has eased to 3.12% in May at a record low. Core inflation, remember, is barring and excluding food and fuel prices. So, Mithali, for those wondering, will the monsoon make them pay less for their vegetables?
So, I think, Sakshi, at this point in time, I will say that I am not seeing that correlation necessarily in vegetable markets with the core inflation. You know, there's a difference between the core inflation, because the core inflation is a leading indicator. So today, if core inflation is at 3.9, it will take maybe a full quarter for, you know, the effect of that leading indicator to reflect in our actual food basket or in our vegetable prices. So definitely at this point in time, I don't see immediate impact of the fall in core inflation. We will still see that, you know, the vegetable prices will remain not very high, but they will be higher than, you know, say the previous quarter. And then in the next quarter, Q3, is when we will start seeing the overall size and the cost of the food basket coming down if this trend in falling inflation continues. And that is highly dependent on our fuel prices. At the end of the day, the biggest contributor to, you know, food prices, vegetable prices, our entire food basket inflation is the logistics cost. So if we are able to reduce the fuel prices and the logistics cost, then definitely, you know, that will start reflecting in the lower cost of vegetables.
Right. Mithali, when do we see this reflection really? You're saying in the medium term, not in the near term.
We will not see it in this quarter, but in Q3, I do think that, you know, we can start to see a stabilization of food prices, particularly vegetable prices, and more and more availability also of the vegetable products. But in the summer, you know, given also the state of damage that is happening to the vegetables at this point in time, what we are observing is that, you know, because of the extreme heat, there is also an impact on the, you know, actual production, on the, you know, transport, on the damage of the crops. And that is also having an impact on the food prices and the vegetable prices in particular, because these are, you know, perishable commodities.
Right. Like you mentioned, you're witnessing this impact due to the heat wave as well. And the RBI governor also recently saying that, look, vegetable prices are experiencing a summer uptick. So do you think this will spill over then in the near term for people?
Absolutely, Sakshi. I think, you know, the monsoon is expected to bring relief. I mean, in more ways than one, you know, when we talk about the heat as well as in terms of the summer uptick of vegetable prices. But we will take some time, definitely, for this to be reflecting in the actual cost of the basket. And I do expect that it will take a quarter, you know, so therefore Q3 is when we can start to expect the moderating prices.
Right. And lastly, what more can India do to continue to contain food inflation? You know, overall inflation, yes, we are seeing it's easing, but what about food inflation?
No, I think, Sakshi, at this point in time, we need two sets of measures. One set of measures is around investment in infrastructure, because we know that, you know, the storage of our crops, the storage of our food products, that is, you know, one of the major reasons for food inflation to continue. So if we invest more in cold storage, if we invest more in, you know, storage facilities, and also the optimal utilization of the storage facilities that we do have, you know, we can bring in a lot more technology to improve the utilization of the cold storage facilities. I often observe that, you know, cold storage facilities are lying empty in some states because, you know, nobody knows that that space is actually available. So if we can have more tech-based, platform-based solutions, you know, to make traders aware that, look, this cold storage facility is available, then that is something that's going to help in reducing food inflation. Now, that's the first one. But the second one is around pricing. And, you know, we know that food prices, especially for certain commodities, are currently heavily regulated. So we have to think about, you know, the regulatory mechanisms, review the regulatory mechanisms and see how can we, you know, have regular updates of those food prices in response and in link, you know, with linkage to inflation. So I think with that, these two sets of measures, infrastructure investment and improved regulation, we will be able to, you know, do a better management of the food prices.
All right. Thank you so much for sharing your perspective and for joining us with your thoughts.